This is my maternal grandfather, Donald Naylor, who served in the U.S. Navy during World War II.
At the time this photo was taken, this Navy sailor couldn't have known it would even be possible for his granddaughter to earn a seat at this desk in CalVet's big office. Secretary of the California Department of Veterans Affairs, Lindsey Sin, is the first woman to hold that title. And while she's new to the job, her experience in the military runs deep.
This is me in boot camp right here. I look so serious. With extremely short hair and a very young face.
Like her grandpa, Secretary Sin is a Navy veteran. She worked in military intelligence overseas, specializing in the Arabic language, including supporting operations Enduring Freedom and Iraqi Freedom.
It sounds like you really enjoyed your time in the Navy.
I did. I think I achieved everything I wanted to. I was able to see the world. I was able to gain great leadership skills.
After 8 years in the Navy, she went to work supporting other veterans as they attended colleges, including her alma mater, Sac State.
I obviously understood their experiences, what it was like coming home for the first time and transitioning from the military. It can be a little overwhelming.
In a past role at CalVet, she focused on the challenges for women veterans. Of our state's 1.6 million vets, about 10% are women.
So they may come out of the military with additional needs. You know, they may not be single, they may have children, they may have spouses, they may be caregivers to their own parents, for example, because women typically are usually the caregiver to their parents. There are a lot of ways that that women's service has to be kind of recognized as its own, own detail.
Of universal concern are the serious issues for the most vulnerable veterans. It's estimated that veterans make up about 10% of California's homeless population. And veterans are 50% more likely to die by suicide than people who have not served in the military.
We will be opening a new skilled nursing facility, state of the art, in our Yountville Veterans Home sometime in the middle of next year. I care a lot about those projects. My passion is certainly with continuing to expand behavioral health services and affordable housing for veterans, because those really are the unmet needs of this current set of veterans that we have here in California.
As a fellow veteran, Secretary Sin says the work is personal. And although she made history reaching this office, she doesn't plan to spend much time in it.
I don't know that that I'll be stuck in this office too much. That's my hope is that I'm not, even though I really enjoy the view. I will continue to go out and meet with people, to tour our offices. In fact, those are some of the first things I'll do, to make sure I visit our veterans' homes, our district offices, and our cemeteries. I love talking to people. I love getting the chance to hear from our veterans. So as much as I can continue to do that, I will.